So you briefly touched in your interaction that RRG can also identify the long-term trends. Can you throw some light how exactly when it moves from one quadrant to another, how it identifies the long-term trends?
That depends on what the time frame is that you select. I mean, RRG is a chart like any other chart. So you have, you know, if we stick to normal regular charts, candlesticks, bar charts, and you want to look at long-term trends, what do you use? Monthly charts, weekly charts.
Right.
You want to see the long-term trend. If you want to use short-term stuff, you go to daily or hourly or 30 minutes or whatever. RRG is the same. If you want to see longer-term trends, you take weekly, maybe monthly for very long-term trends. If you're a little bit more trading orientated, you can go to daily. We can also do like hourly RRGs. I've got Forex traders who use RRGs on 1 minute or 5 minute basis to see the rotation of a basket of currencies throughout the day.
Okay.
So, you know, it's like, you know when you take away price and time from a chart and you show it to someone and you ask, you know, what is the time here? Is that 1 year? Is it 10 years? Is it 100 years? Is it 2 days? You can't tell. Mm-hmm. It's the same with an RRG. If you take away, you know, whether it's a weekly, a daily, or a 5 minute RRG, you wouldn't be able to tell. It's just, it shows the same rotational pattern, it's the same fractal, it's all the same. So.
Okay.